Our lab focuses on mapping thinking onto the dorsal and ventral processing streams of the brain. The dorsal stream is very analytical and controlled, and it specializes in representing where something is in our environment and how we interact with it. Whereas the ventral stream is very holistic and automatic and specializes in identifying what the object is. When we ask fMRI participants to either say what a target picture or word is, where it is located on the screen, or how they would interact with it, we see this distinction quite clearly. On the right panel, unique picture activation is in yellow, word activation is in blue, and on the left panel, the shared activation is shown in green. We're also very interested in reading processes and how the dorsal stream represents analytical phonetic decoding, whereas the ventral stream represents holistic or lexical reading. We see this distinction when we ask fMRI participants to either phonetically decode pseudohomophones, which are non-words that sound like words, and they're shown on the right in blue, or holistically read exception words, and these are words that can't be phonetically decoded, shown in yellow. Controlled attention involves more of the dorsal stream, whereas reflexive or automatic attention involves more of the ventral stream. We recently showed this distinction when examining the sharing of ventral stream regions of reflexive attention with lexical reading of exception words on the left side in red, and of dorsal stream regions of controlled attentional processing with pseudohomophone phonetic decoding on the right side in yellow. Our lab also applies this basic research to help neurosurgeons localize function and structure in patients about to undergo surgery for either dorsal stream impairments, in this case using diffusion tensor imaging and basic motor fMRI for a dorsal astrocytoma, or in this case, ventral stream impairments in temporal lobe epilepsy using fMRI of lexical reading of exception words. We also combine analyses of behavior and brain to guide the development of computational models of cognitive processing. Here we show how manipulating instructions for reading can affect behavioral reaction time and brain activation, which informs our models in terms of when various stages of processing occur and where they are located. Finally, I'd like to thank NSERC for continuous support of this research and my students.